lifting Vaughn up there on that stretcher. Hard to say which leg it is. Langlois hits it off the board. Bob Vaughn lets it drive. It goes good!
Gives it into the bear back to LeFou. The Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup.
We did with Nystrom. Tonelli to Nystrom. He scores!
The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
Time once again to go back into the archives. Welcome to Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. I'm Dan Pollard. Today we look back at May 3rd of 1979, the Wales semifinal between the Boston Bruins and the three-time defending champion Montreal Canadiens. The Canadiens had not lost a playoff series to the Bruins since 1943, and that seemed unlikely to change when the Habs won the first two games at the Forum. Boston head coach Don Cherry guaranteed the Bruins were not done. They trailed 2-1 in the series after winning Game 3. Now they played a pivotal Game 4, needing a win to avoid heading back to Montreal facing elimination.
And so we are ready. It's O'Reilly on the right side, McNabb going to center. Jonathan, who got the first goal for Boston on Tuesday night, on the left side, and Shartrock, Ganey, and Jarvis for Montreal. And the Canadiens roll it in on the left side. They go in after it. Sims shoots it off the boards, down the ice it goes. It'll be icing in all probability against Boston.
The lineup changes for the Bruins. Wayne Cashman playing, as you saw. The Canadiens have Mark Napier back in the lineup, and Guy Lapointe on defense, who missed the other night. Napier has not played since the Toronto series. Pierre Larouche and Rod Langway not in uniform tonight for Montreal. And Gary Dornhofer is with us again. He is in his uniform in the broadcast booth as we look at Don Cherry. He's had a new suit every game. Different suit every game.
Well, if you were making the kind of money Don Cherry and you make, you'd have suits a couple of times a day. Now the Bruins into the corner. Here's Sims. Up it goes into the center ice area. Jonathan went up against Tremblay. Now Riley hit Tremblay. McNabb cleared it in. It's around the board. Lombard is belted by Jonathan. They struggle on the boards. Piling in there. This is giving some indication in the early seconds that it might yet be the most rugged of the four games played so far.
Well, Jonathan, he certainly is a tough customer, and because of that injury, he didn't play the way he did last year, but that goal that he got on Tuesday night certainly has to help him, and they need a lot of production from this fellow.
Okay, they line up to the left of Dryden. We have Lemaire, Lafleur, and Ganey as a forward line for the Canadiens. Rattel out with Cashman and Marcotte. Here's Robinson. He probably has been the best Canadiens in the entire playoffs. Ganey going in on the left side, and Rick Smith takes him out of the play. Lafleur is dumped behind the net by Milbury. Rattel is belted by Ganey. Oh, and a check on Rattel by Ganey, and there's the point. Taking his man out of the play, Marcotte. Puck is down the ice. Back for it goes Rick Smith. No icing. They stop there. Cashman has it behind the net. Here's Cashman up on the left side to Marcotte, along with Rattel. Rattel is dumped this time by Guy Lafleur. Now here's Milbury trying to get a shot. It rolls right in front of the net. And it's off Cashman's stick to the corner. Robinson twisting and turning in the corner to Lafleur. Ahead it goes to Lapointe. Lapointe into the center ice area, over the line. In for Ganey. Ganey cleared it to the other side, and it's back down the ice. My goodness, the body checking in the first 2 minutes. Now it's Hughes coming down. He flipped it ahead at the line. Miller gets it into the center ice area. Engblom feeding it in. And the Bruins in there to pick it up. There's no score in this robust hockey game so far. There is Park ahead up on the left side. Sims shooting it in. Engblom in there to cover up against Middleton. Engblom snaps the shot. Park stops it. Here's Park. Park going in. He centered it to Miller. There's the shot. And an outstanding save by Dryden. Now Canadians coming down. Mondo going in. He fired! And a splendid save by Gilbert.
And so the period off to a rousing start. Great goaltending already, Gary.
They're continuing right where they left off Tuesday night. What an exhibition.
Now it's Connor on the boards. Back it goes. There's the shot right on by Sharpaw. And Gilbert had to be very sharp. Jonathan getting it out on the left side is down into Montreal territory. McNabb is watching Savard. The Bruins in there forechecking, led by O'Reilly, Jonathan, and McNabb. Now the Canadians got rid of it. Up on the side it goes to Jonathan. He whipped the shot right on. That didn't give Dryden too much trouble. Now the Canadians. Here is Jarvis along with Connor. And that shot was off the leg of Milbury, and it's offside.
Well, goaltenders like to get into a game early, Gary, and they can't complain tonight, I'll tell you. First it was Dryden off Miller, and then right here, Mondu with a breakaway.
Again, the breakaway early in the game. Watch this save.
Well, I thought that Gilbert, looking at it, because he wasn't quite with good balance, but he made the stop. This was Dryden just before that, off Miller from the left side. Pad save on the low shot.
You know, Miller had Dryden sliding over to his right, and he was just trying to slide it at that far goalpost, but Dryden was equal to the task, and it was a great setup by Brad Parker.
Face off outside the Bruins blue line. Brad Park clearing it up on the left side for Marcotte. Cashman trying to knock down a high pass. Robinson ahead to Ganey, and Park very coolly cleared it to center. Lemaire, it's off the leg. Lafleur, who has been non-productive on the road for the Canadians in the playoffs, he couldn't get anywhere that time. Here's Lemaire going in on a shot along the ice wide on the right side. Cashman got it out. Canadians are on it again, and they feed it back in there. Number 10 Lafleur is watching Cashman. Now Dick Redmond ahead of goes. Lapointe clearing it back in. Lambert, a backhand shot to the corner. Canadians in there on top of the Bruins. Marcotte starting out. There's a pass broken up by Robinson. And it's Park backtracking over on the other side. Ashman turning at the line. Ahead it goes to Foster up on the left side. Marcotte going in. Down the boards it goes. Lambert's pass is stopped at the line by Foster. Coming up quickly, Lapointe, he's over the line. There's the shot, the rebound. Lambert is shooting it. And Gilbert comes up big again. Here's Lambert into the corner. Park out on the left side. Marcotte to Cashman. Cashman is over the line trying to get through there. And it's Lapointe ahead to Lambert. So you saw Gilbert very, very sharp again on Lapointe and Lambert. Now the Bruins led by Miller. Over the line with Middleton offside.
Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Boston Garden.
Canadians have always had a healthy opinion of Swiss Chalet. It's little things like how they feel right at home here.
Look who's home.
And our wholesome meals, like our new family dinner, a whole rotisserie chicken, a family-sized salad, and your choice of two large sides. Priced so a family of four can eat well for under $30. So there's one other little thing Canadians love. The bill.
Food you can feel good about. Swiss Chalet.
Nissan Murano. And as it turns out, so can you.
Here I am, 50 years old, and I'm out in a bikini, and that makes me feel very good.
How can a 50-year-old grandmother look this good? Simple. She strength trains with Bowflex.
I'm 50 years old and I have a Bowflex body.
Call the number on your screen now to get a free video or DVD that shows you how you can get great results with Bowflex.
My results are very real. I lost 17 pounds in the first 5 weeks on my Bowflex. I'm leaner, I'm happier, I'm sexier than I've ever been.
All it takes for great results is one simple workout done 20 minutes a day, 3 days a week.
It's safe, it's reliable, and I can get a good workout from head to toe.
Own your very own Bowflex Extreme for no money down and payments of just $18 a month. No matter what your age, if you want real results, you need a real Bowflex. Call us for a free DVD or video, or visit us online today.
Now on the faceoff, Ganey lost it. Redmond clearing it ahead to Middleton with Rattell over the line, trying to lead Rattell in, and it's broken up, and Ganey speeds back to center, playing it to LaPointe. LaPointe snapped a shot into the corner area, and there behind the net, Ganey. Now Jarvis has it. He sent it right out in front, and Ganey couldn't pick it up, and Middleton starts back, hands it off to Brad Park. Park over the line. There's the shot. Park plays off. Rebound cleared by Dryden. Now the Bruins try desperately to keep it in, but Rattell had to go out, and now they're back there to regroup. No score in the hockey game. Here's Redmond winding up. Oh, that was a blistering shot, but it was wide. Now it went all the way down the ice. Bruins are back there to get it. The teams are making changes while the play goes on. Now Miller on the right side lost it to Savard. No score in the hockey game. Exactly 7 minutes left. They are playing five aside, and they will continue to do so with the proviso and other penalties for the next 50 seconds. There's LaPointe going in there. LaPointe trying to get away from Redmond. Miller and LaPointe, they jam, and they get a... No, it almost was a stoppage. Referee had the whistle to his mouth. He didn't blow it. LaFleur back to Savard. Savard takes a look. Shot is wide. LaPointe back, gives it to LaFleur. Here's LaFleur sending it right in front of the net. Park has lost his stick. Ahead it goes to Miller. Miller into the center ice area to Marcotte. He drifts the shot away wide. LaPointe is in there against Marcotte. It comes to the side of the net, and there's Savard nimbly picking his way out, and he gives it to Lemaire. Lemaire back at his line. Now there are 2 seconds left in the penalties. They are out of the penalty box. Robinson and Milbury. Now Savard at the line. Ahead it goes to Lemaire with Tremblay on the right side. There's the shot nowhere near the net. O'Reilly laying it back. Sims up on the left side to Marcotte to Miller. In it goes. Robinson after it. O'Reilly got Robinson. He centered it back. It comes to Jonathan. There's the shot. Rebound. And the Canadians, three of them starting out. Broken up at center by Rick Smith. Here's Robinson rolling it into Boston territory. O'Reilly up ahead. It goes on the left side. Into Canadians territory, back into the corner. That is Risebrow. He flipped it high into the air. O'Reilly dumped Risebrow. They're beginning to lay the body on again. Rick Smith ahead. It goes to O'Reilly. O'Reilly in over the line. Canadians clearing it back to center. Sims handing it off to Smith. It's returned to Sims. Now O'Reilly going to the corner. He's going after Robinson. Jonathan trying to get Robinson. He missed. Puck is down to the Boston line. Now McNabb tearing it up on the wing, and there's Robinson back. Jonathan is watching him. Jonathan going after Robinson. Now the puck is at the line. Brad Park over goes to Smith. There's a shot. It rolls in. And Dryden has the puck under him. That was excellent pressure by Boston. There is still no score in the hockey game, and it's Savard on the right side. Savard out over the line. Ganey has the pass go off his skate. He campers in there by Park. Now Chartrand trying to get it along with Jarvis against Cashman. They jam it on the board. And the faceoff will be in Bruin territory.
Well, Wayne Cashman, quite a story, as you heard in his conversation with Dave Hodge off the top of the show. Much bigger surprise that he was in uniform the other night than tonight. They had totally wiped him out of the picture apparently on Tuesday, but there he was.
Well, he figured if he could help in even a small way, he'd rather be a part of it. And you know, he does so much for the Bruins. Corner work in front of the net. Very valuable player.
Canadians with the defense playing up. However, the Bruins get the draw on Redmond. Fires it through center, right on Dryden. And that direction eliminated an icing. Now a short draw over the line ahead to Ganey. Ganey in over the line, a long weak shot. There's Jarvis centering it, and it goes to the board. Ganey keeping it in. Park has it for Boston to Redmond. Redmond with Rattel. Rattel into the center ice area. Moss is going in against Lupier. Ganey fired it to the far side, and that's the signal for Montreal and also the Bruins to make changes while the play goes on. There's no score. First period, 9 minutes and 28 seconds remaining. Here is Napier. Napier at the line, gives it to Lupien. Over at the line, brought in, offside is Hughes.
Steve Shutt missing from the Montreal lineup tonight. It had been hoped he'd play Saturday, but apparently that will not be the case. There is Mark Napier, who was injured on a play in the first overtime period, Gary. You were there of game three in Toronto in the quarterfinals. The play in which he came within an eyelash of scoring the overtime winning goal, fell back of the Leaf net and hurt his knee. Hasn't seen any action until right now.
Well, his speed will certainly be welcomed by the Canadiens tonight. So we'll see what he can do.
From the faceoff, Rick Smith. Off the boards to Milbury. He's shoved off the puck by Hughes. It's loose and it's grabbed off by Robinson. Robinson shooting in. Here's Bondue getting it back. Napier to Robinson, back to Napier. Puck is loose in the Boston zone. Milbury, a very much improved player for Boston, clearing it. Robinson has to get it over to LaPointe, ahead into the center ice area to Bondue. And Napier was way offside on that.
Still no score. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Boston Garden.
It took some practice, but we finally perfected salads from the grill. Harvey's new Garden Fresh Salads, made fresh daily with grilled seasoned chicken. Come and get it.
Longer-lasting Axe Effect, Axe Deodorant Body Spray.
Hello, Moto.
Is coming, which is big news. They played sold-out big shows in big, big stadiums. And after 3 long years, their first North American show is in Canada. But not here.
They're playing in a small club. The first of 3 Molson Canadian Rockstar concerts this summer. You could be there if you open up a specially marked case of Molson Canadian and find a Rockstar access pass. Must be legal drinking age, no purchase necessary. It starts here.
Don Cherry, the face-off in the center ice area. As Gary Dornhofer has indicated, the pressure is still on the Bruins in this series. They cannot afford the luxury of a loss here tonight and go back to Montreal down 3-1. So it's a determined Boston team to tie up this series at 2 games. Out there against the Canadiens at the moment, and Montreal starting at the line. They have to go back after it. Napier chopped it into the center ice area. Here is Milbury waiting for McNabb to get onside. Milbury over to O'Reilly. O'Reilly trying to get it back. Hughes is bumped. Puck is down on the left side. There's Rick Smith hammering it off the glass into the center ice area. Big McNabb is over the line. Puts on the brakes. In for Jonathan. And Mondu is there for the Canadiens. Ahead in on the right side to Trombley. Trombley to Napier. He fakes the shot, trying to get through there. The puck is into the corner. Donovan is bumping with Trombley. The Bruins are coming by. O'Reilly into the centerized area. And that's called on the offside. 7:48 left in the opening period. No score.
They are just past the midway mark of the first period tonight at Madison Square Garden. The Islanders and the Rangers are scoreless, with the Rangers leading that series 2-1. And when there are scoring plays in that game, we will bring them to you on our broadcast of this Montreal-Boston game. Some heavy slugging with Stan Jonathan, Gary.
Not a bad exchange there. I'll tell you, both teams mean business tonight.
And the Bruins with Park the leader, getting it out to the line. He hit Rattel to Cashman. It's dumped into the corner. There is Marcotte trying to center it against Savard. Keeney on the left side for Montreal. Pass goes to center, and the Bruins defense up into the center ice area often, as you can see there, breaking up a lot of these plays. Here's Cashman. Cashman over the line. Taken into the boards rather robustly by Engblom. Rattel got in there too, along with Gainey. So the faceoff will be in the Canadian zone. No score.
Before we get too wrapped up in the proceedings here tonight, a bit of hockey news today. Fred Creighton was released as coach of the Atlanta Flames, a team that's had only two coaches in its 7 years in the NHL, Boom Boom Jeffrey-Ott and then Creighton. No replacement named as yet.
So Cashman gets a hand as he goes off. There's Middleton barging in with Rattel. Rattel is around the net. He's getting set. He jams it, and Dryden is down on all fours, and he holds it out. Middleton was right there, number 16.
I don't think that Rattel saw Middleton there. All he did was, and he came from around behind the net, he shoveled it in front. But look at Marcotte there, just high in the slot. Now I think we're still going to have to watch that area, you know, getting that man deeper in the slot for the Bruins.
Into the boards, Lemaire falling heavily against Marcotte. So the faceoff will come up again against Ken Dryden. Has a career playoff average of 1.87 against Boston. Plays very well.
Following up that Atlanta story, Cliff Fletcher, the Flames general manager, will be guesting with Dave Hodge during the second intermission on our show tonight. Jacques Lemaire fell into the boards, Gary, and he was pointing to his skate. He has gone to the Montreal dressing room. He could have lost the edge there as he slammed into the boards.
Talking about Dryden, he got a penalty the other night, the second time in his career in the playoffs. It was 73 against Buffalo. In overtime, they measured his pads. Remember that?
That's right, yes.
No score. Now Rattel going in after Savard. Canadians starting out short, draw to Jarvis on the left side is Gainey. Gainey going after it along the boards. Had he not touched it, it would have been icing had Boston got in there. Now they fight for it. Here is Chartra dumping it out, and it goes all the way down the ice. 6 minutes and 37 seconds left in this, the opening period. Captain Savard is leading a four-man Canadian put back into the center ice area, not too far. Here is Sims coming down. There's the shot, and a split close save there by Dryden. In on the boards. They fight for possession. Miller is bouncing after it, but Savard got it to center. Here is Milbury. Into the corner it goes. Engblom being watched by Miller. Dryden gets it out there. It comes right back in. It came back in for Wensick. Here's Lafleur on the right side. There's the shot, and it's off a stick. Wheeling back for Boston, Miller. He takes a long shot. Schmotz is on the ice coming from the right side. Canadians getting it to the line. Here's Lafleur with Hughes and Lapointe. Draw pass to Lapointe, and he drills the shot just wide. It's centered right in front, and Schmotz back for Boston. Schmotz ahead on the left side. Mark Hoppe Schmotz, there's the shot. And it's called on the offside.
Hey, do you know where the... what?
I want to take you somewhere.
I'm free for dinner.
In San Francisco?
That would be nice.
We could go back to that little seafood place. Our hotel's only a block away. But this time, we'll have a view of the bay. And I booked a trolley tour right before our sunset cruise.
Planning a trip with Expedia.ca means getting your trip your way.
Happy 12th anniversary.
13th.
Yes.
Expedia.ca. Flights, hotels, car rentals, packages. Now we're getting somewhere.
Repairs at Minute and Speedy Muffler are about the best and surest things around. Whether it's a clamp on a shaky tailpipe or an entire new muffler, our professionals will do the job right, keeping Canadians quietly on the road.
With its long wheelbase, second and third row fold flat seats, and dedicated storage space, there's plenty of cargo room in your Quest for any spontaneous shopping sprees that may occur on the way home. The stylish 240 horsepower Nissan Quest. Lease one today at your Nissan dealer.
Oasis is coming, which is big news. They played sold-out big shows in big, big stadiums. And after 3 long years, their first North American show is in Canada. But not here.
They're playing in a small club. The first of 3 Molson Canadian Rockstar concerts this summer. You could be there if you open up a specially marked case of Molson Canadian and find a Rockstar access pass. Must be legal drinking age, no purchase necessary. It starts here.
Okay, we have LaFleur. Coach Bowman now has LaFleur playing center ice to try to get away from Marcotte. As you know, Marcotte, he's been watching him here in the Boston Garden, so maybe this will alleviate him, and he can do some forechecking and help out that way.
You notice Schmatz, number 11, ordinarily he has a great shot. He's not getting much on it. He has an arm, shoulder, or hand, some part of the anatomy bothering him. That's essential and necessary in shooting. There's LaFleur, in it goes, in to the side of the net. Behind the net to the side, LaFleur dumping it, it's into the crease, and it's cleared away. A sprawling Gilbert gets up off his back. Canadians coming very close there. There's that head fake by LaFleur, dancing away LaFleur. Back to Lapointe. Lapointe playing a very aggressive first period for the Canadians. Now it's in behind the net. Milbury trying to cover up, and he succeeds face-off in Boston territory, 4:57.
Oh, Gary, you were right. LaFleur forechecking isn't necessarily one of his strong points, but he almost set up Napier right there, who just failed to click a Gilbert from very close range right at the goal crease. This is the play here. It's amazing. Whenever LaFleur shovels that puck in front, it always seems like it wants to go in. But Gilbert had some anxious moments there, but the puck certainly didn't get over that line. We're still scoreless.
Now it's Montreal's turn to send the defense, this time of Lupien and Savard, in over the line. Back it goes. They can't keep it in. Here is an outstanding player for Boston in the entire series, O'Reilly. O'Reilly around the net, trying to shove it to. They score!
Big mistake, and the Bruins have taken a 1-0 lead.
Well, it's great when you have that good forechecking, and just a lot of hustle here by O'Reilly. He loses possession of the puck. Watch it come out right in front, and Rattel shovels it home. But a mad scramble there. Robinson and Dryden both out of position. It's laying there, and I think Rattel's going to get a hold of it. There it goes. Jonathan did some great work in front. Everybody was involved.
Well, it all happened in rather innocent fashion to begin with. Dryden left his net, and Lupien was knocked off the puck, and the Bruins lead it 1-0.
So the Bruins leading 1-0. Here's Rattel clearing it in again. The time of the goal. I think that's what I picked up on the PA. Now the puck is at the Boston line. It's out over the line. Here's O'Reilly with Jonathan. Back to O'Reilly. O'Reilly getting it to Sims. There's the shot. And it's blocked by Jarvis out to center. Chartrand on the right side. The pass goes into Gilbert, and he covers up. So the Bruins leading 1-0 in the first period, as they did in that great game on Tuesday night.
Rattel from O'Reilly, the scoring play, 15-15, Rattel's fifth goal of the playoffs.
Here I was blaming Robinson on that play, and it was Lupien. But that just goes to show you what happens if you have that first man in there, you know, with a lot of speed, because the defenseman, not only does he have to worry about the puck, he has to worry about the man coming in on you.
So let's see now what's going to happen for this faceoff to the left of Gilbert. 4:02 left in the opening period. Lafleur back to LaPointe. There's a shot. Rick Smith got in front of it. Robinson keeping it in. There's a shot right on. Didn't have too much, but it was screened. Now Gainey clearing it to the other side. Here's Marcotte. Ahead into the center ice area. Robinson to Gainey. Gainey back on the left side. Milbury clearing it out for Boston. LaPointe trying to get something going for Montreal. Fails to negotiate with that pass to Gainey. Now it's out over the line. Robinson takes over, dumping it in. It's strictly Montreal picking it up at center, throwing it in there, trying to get possession. Gainey jostling with Milbury. I think that's Milbury. They were going at it pretty solidly.
Now the Bruins have the lead here at Madison Square Garden. The New York Rangers, we are told, put the puck in the Islanders' net, but the goal was disallowed, causing a bit of a hassle. Still scoreless up there, the Rangers and the Islanders.
Is that something that the Islanders need to get them going, Gary Dornhofer? No, they may need more than that.
They better get playing or they're going to be watching the finals.
Now it's Sims shooting it up. And it is over the glass. 3:13 left in this, the opening period. We have not got a running tabulation of shots on goal. And it'll be interesting to see what they're like at the end of the first.
Gilbert's been much busier here tonight. I think almost as busy as he was through the first two periods on Tuesday.
Well, the Canadians are certainly doing what they said they had to do. Is, you know, as soon as they get over that red line, you know, with that short area between the two blue lines, they're firing it in. And one thing they do have is they're both forwards are going in there with a lot of speed, and then they're able to get on top of the Bruin defenseman.
From the draw, the Bruins starting out, three of them into the center ice area. Marcotte chops a shot into the corner. Off the glass, came back to Robinson. Robinson leading the attack into the center ice area, down to the Boston line. Here's Robinson shooting it in, and Park, his counterpart on defense, gets it out to Marcotte. Marcotte over the line. That one off. LaPointe stick and ricocheted to the angle to the wing. Robinson out into the center. I see those forwards going back. You have four Bruins across the line. A centering pass. Now it's cleared out over the line. It was interesting to see that time, the forwards coming back so beautifully for Boston, with the result when the Canadians hit the line, you had two forwards and two defensemen lined up. It's shot in there again. Rattel is bumped. Now Tremblay trying to get a pass. He's digging in the corner along with Mondu. And the play is stopped.
Oh man, take mine.
Thanks.
Nah, I'd love to spend my holidays up here. I got no place to stay.
You can use my cottage. Kevin, yeah, you okay?
Susie dumped me.
Have you met Julie?
It's the last one.
Moose Light. Enjoy your nature.
Sunroof, V6 power, and the highest crash test rating. The 2005 Suzuki XL7.
Introducing the Mr. Clean Auto Drive Pro Series Car Wash Kit. It has everything you need to clean your car. The upgraded device features a powerful new jet spray setting to help remove tough dirt. Pour in the dry rinse polymer soap to help sheet water off your car. After rinsing, load the filter and switch to the auto-dry setting to get a spot-free shine with no need to hand-dry, guaranteed. Go to autodry.com for special offers and more information.
Dick, I don't think I've ever seen Rattell hit as often as in his first period. There's a shot right on the rebound. Lambert goes sprawling. He was looking for the rebound. Close call there.
Well, there's no doubt that Rattell, I think, Gary, if you're looking at this series overall from a Boston standpoint, from the forwards, okay, Park is outstanding on defense. You've got to go with Rattell as their
question. He does so many things, face-offs, and handles that puck so well, making plays.
Now shot, screenshot. Gilbert down again, 1-0 for Boston. Here's Rattell. They can't clear it out. There's a shot right on. Who's puck? And it's cleared away by Rattell. Gilbert didn't know where it was. Great scoring opportunities for the Canadians. Now Lambert in over the line to the right side. Trombley couldn't get it. And it's a penalty coming up here. O'Reilly arguing along with Milbury with the referee, Wally Harris.
Boy, what a flurry that was by the Risebrough Trombley Lambert line. Gilbert has just been outstanding here tonight.
What an opportunity here. Gilbert, he's got it caught right between his pads, and look at the clear out by Milbury there. Now that's what you call taking the man out of the play. There it is there, just laying there, and in comes Milbury and does his job.
Right.
But the Canadians are applying the pressure. There's no question about that.
18-13 of the first period. Terry O'Reilly, there he is. He's in the penalty box, and he was caught somewhere along the way by referee Harris, roughing the call. So the Canadians with the game's first power play opportunity.
Big opportunity for Montreal. However, power play goals have not been numerous in this series, particularly here at the Boston Garden. So let's see what eventuates on this one. In it goes, a Milbury whipped it out to Marcotte. Marcotte into the center ice area. Lobbed it to the corner. We have Marcotte and Redmond up front. Milbury and Smith. Dallas Redmond trying to center it. Canadians intercept. Lapointe with Robinson, Lafleur, and Lambert. They're in over the Boston line. To Lapointe. There's the shot. Puck is loose in front. A scramble. They still back away at it. And the referee indicates no goal.
What great position Wally Harris had on that one. He's right behind the net, has a great view of it. And that's what you call getting yourself in good position. Look at this flurry.
Well, the pressure has been tremendous on Gilbert. But through it all, Gary, they didn't really get a good crack at the puck.
Right. You think the puck doesn't attract people?
A standing ovation for Gilbert here at the Garden. What a story that is. He played in only 23 games this regular season. Had played in only one playoff game in the last 2 years prior to his first star performance Tuesday night in game three in the semifinal.
Yeah, Don Cherry, he probably talked to Blue again today. Got things straightened out.
Canadians still on the power play, back to Lapointe. Here is Lapointe taking a shot, the rebound, they score! Mondeau on the rebound. Something had to give, and it gave there.
Well, again, you get the situation as we see some of the Montreal fans, and there are a few here in the building. Gary, you get the situation of you just can't take penalties against the Canadians. They haven't taken many, but by golly, they get one here tonight, and it's a tie hockey game.
That's right. Gilbert made the initial save, and then when he was down, he just couldn't get the rebound, get up again. And in fact, he tried to jump up, and puck slid right underneath him.
If he'd have stayed on the ice, it wouldn't have got by him. Tried to move over, and the puck went beneath Gilbert. So there you see the reaction of Don Cherry, who didn't like the penalty in the first place. 1-1 tie.
Now there's a bouncing shot wide, 55 seconds left. Here's Cashman centering it right out in front. Jarvis clearing it behind. Cashman against Chartres. Now on the boards, we'll give you a recap on that scoring play. When the opportunity presents itself, right now the Canadians starting out. A lead pass for Gainey. Gainey coming in over on this side. Engblom trying to get it. Sims ahead to Miller. Miller chopping it, and it goes off Engblom over the glass. Have you got a recap on that scoring?
On the power play, Mondeau, his second of the playoffs from Lapointe. And it came at 18:59 as there's a bit of a hassle, but nothing developing. Incidentally, some of the fans may be wondering when Gary said Don Cherry checked with Blue today, he meant his dog Blue, not Vida.
You know, Don Cherry always talks to Blue on any decisions that he has to make, and so far things have worked out pretty well for him. Gainey, he really rode Miller out against the boards there, and Miller, of course, had fire in his eyes.
Stick one into the Canadiens bench and knock Mario Tremblay right back off the bench. That's Tremblay's yelling back at Miller right there.
So there are 26 seconds left in this opening period, a goal apiece. And it is Savard ahead. He misses Gainey with it. This could be icing. It is against Montreal. So a big faceoff here with 17 seconds left in the period.
Certainly is. And what a game this guy had last night. And you give Brad Park a lot of time, and he'll just get that puck up to the center iceman or the wing every single time. And so I think that Montreal, every chance they have, they want to bump him a little bit and throw the puck at him, make him work extra hard, and perhaps by the third period, you know, he won't be able to do that as effectively.
It's wonderful how these hockey players can reach back, though, Gary. Remember how you used to go so strongly in the third period? Now it's out over the line. Back to Jonathan on the right side. Cashman jammed in on the boards, and it goes to the right side. Chartrand to Jarvis, and that is the end of the period. Jonathan and Jarvis started something, and the bench is clear to the blue line area. Nothing very serious as yet.
This is a case when the benches can legally be cleared. Just as the siren went, you had Jarvis hit the deck. Chartrand took exception in the direction of Stan Jonathan. The shots on goal here now for you. Canadians outshot the Bruins 12-8 in the first period. Montreal has been limited to an average of just a fraction over 20 shots a game through the first three games of this series, which of course is far below their regular average. But here in this first period tonight, as Gary pointed out, they did exactly what they have to do against the Bruins or anybody else if they play their game, and that is go to the attack, get lots of shots on goal, and particularly get lots of scoring chances. They did, and it paid off finally with that power play goal to tie the game.
Longer-lasting Axe Effect, Axe Deodorant Body Spray.
Spring is here. Time to break out the Armor and the Armor All Tire Foam. Clean and protect your tires with Armor All. It's strong protection.
If starting your gas trimmer is more like a workout, ask your local Steel dealer about the amazing new Easy to Start system. Why, it's so easy to start, anyone can do it. Steel, built to last, priced to sell.
Thanks for a wonderful evening.
It's my pleasure. Hey, is this your car?
Not on a first date. But, you want some coffee?
Okay.
The 265-horsepower Nissan Maxima. Lease one today.
Of all the riches in the world, which do you thirst for? Is it the magic of gold? Bright, crisp, clean and pure, with a luster few can match. Does your cup runneth over? It's your kingdom. Bask in the glow.
Hi, I'm Pat LaFontaine. You're watching the NHL Network, and it's always hockey season here.
So here we go. McNabb is at center, Marcotte, and O'Reilly on the wings. Lemaire at center, Gainey and Lafleur from Montreal. Lapointe and Robinson on defense, Park and Sims. So the second period is underway, and Park has it, and he slides a pass ahead. Sims gives it to Marcotte. His pass back. Lemaire clearing it into the center ice area, ahead to Lafleur, offside.
In the important area of faceoffs, there were 28 of them in the first period. The Canadians won 16, the Bruins 12. Dougie Jarvis won 10 of 12 that he took. There's Guy Lafleur, who finished not first, not second, but third this year in the NHL scoring race after three straight scoring championships. In behind the winner, Brian Frache and Marcel Dion of the LA Kings.
Faceoff in the center ice area. Back it goes to Sims to Park, ahead to McNabb. Knocked off his stick. Here's O'Reilly. Now loose puck is picked up by Park. He starts in. He drops it back to McNabb. He cleared it in front. And Lapointe, who had a very strong period, gets it ahead to Lafleur. There's the shot. Hard shot. Rebound. And the Bruins taking over into the center ice area. O'Reilly ahead to McNabb going in. And it's called on the offside.
Boy, that was a close one as Lapointe was trapped on the play. And the Bruins had a 3-on-1 offside down the right wing on the part of Terry O'Reilly.
You know, in a case like that, coaches, they just tear out their hair. You know, when you have that 2-on-1 or 3-on-1 break, the last thing you want to do is go offside, because you just don't get that many chances in a game. And to nullify it by an offside, wow. Well, at least Terry has a little smile about it, but I don't think he's very happy at the time.
Grimace, I think, not a smile.
Rattel along with Cashman and Jonathan facing the Canadiens line of Jarvis, Connor, and Chatra. Now the puck is along the boards, and the faceoff will take place in the Canadian zone in this period, getting off to a bit of a staggering start with the frequency of whistles.
Well, I think both teams will certainly be very cautious. You know, the way the goaltenders are playing, the next goal, you know, that could win the game. So you don't want to make a mistake out there.
Milbury and Rick Smith, they are well in over the Montreal line for the faceoff. Back to Rick Smith. It went off Connor. Robinson slides it to the right side. Milbury keeping it in, a screenshot. Connor gets rid of it, and it's down the ice. Striding back after it, Milbury, and that is icing against Montreal. A minute and 12 seconds have gone by in the second period with the score tied at a goal.
Ken Dryden tonight playing in his 104th Stanley Cup playoff game. He played in his very first one, as we have reminded you, probably a little too much, back in 1971. And there is the Canadiens captain, Ivan Cornoyer, a spectator. We were talking with him. He's more nervous as a spectator than as a player.
That's right. He said, I feel worse now. Here I'm trying to help my guys out there, and I can't do a thing from this seat.
So we have a lot of the Canadiens official family here tonight. Ruel, Blake, Curry, Mouton, DeRoche, Sam Maislin, and they will join the team on a special plane back to Montreal at the end of the game tonight. So they struggle for the puck. Engblom clears it to the other side. Connor, he shoots it down the ice, and they certainly are playing it very cautiously in the opening minutes of this, the second period. Face off to the left of Dryden. Back it goes to Brad Park. Over to Redmond, there's the shot. And it may have hit Lapointe in front of Dryden. Connor playing it back into the corner. The Bruins are on the move. Here's Cashman. Cashman on the boards. Rattel in there to help out. Rattel has it to Cashman. It comes to the side of the net. Cashman tunneling it. And Dryden is down. And he gloves it. The traffic very heavy in front of the Montreal goal.
In New York, it's 1-1. Maloney scored for the Rangers. Don Maloney and then John Tonelli tied the game. Both goals coming, I guess that's early in the second period. And so that's the situation, 1-1.
This is a fine job by the Boston Bruins in that line that just went off. Cashman especially doing a fine job of forechecking. Had a good chance there.
The score is tied at a goal early here in the second period. Miller jammed in on the board. Savard trying to get it loose. Here's Schmatz around the net. He's centered it. Back it goes, Marcotte. Marcotte along the board. He dumped it in behind the net. Lapointe for Montreal. Flicked it high into the air. And that is Milbury with it. Milbury ahead to Schmatz. He tried to tip it by Lapointe. Watch for Miller. Miller on the boards. Back it goes to Milbury. He slides it in there. Now Dryden left it there for Savard. Canadians getting it out over the line, down on the left side. Napier across the line and Marcotte. He's checked by Lafleur. He's checking at times in this period because of the cautious play of a suffocatingly frustrating variety. Now into the corner, Savard. He gloved it to the other side. Lafleur gets it to the line. Out it comes, and it's offside against the Bruins.
Serge Savard of the Canadiens wearing the C in the absence of the injured Ivan Cornoyer. Tonight, Savard playing in his 110th Stanley Cup playoff game. But he and his Canadian teammates, Gary, through the first couple of minutes of this period, have been backed into their own zone.
Well, the Bruins are doing an excellent job. And one thing that when the Canadiens have the puck and the pressure's on them, they fire it around the board, just like most teams do. And that's a real opportunity for defense to pinch in and try to get a good shot from that point area.
Now Lombaire out into the center ice area. Risebrough couldn't get anywhere. Big Robinson is going to try it. He's upended just inside the line. Matt Park bumping on the boards with Lombaire. Big McNabb moving in with Tremblay. There's a shot by Robinson, a low drive wide. Canadians keeping it in. Lombaire out of the net. Gilbert came out. Now it's off the board. Park. Mark along the boards with Lombaire. Canadians taking a turn, hemming the Bruins in. Tremblay trying to get it in front. Now O'Reilly. O'Reilly coming out, makes that good move. Out over the line. Robinson knocks it to the right side, and Tremblay takes over to Lombaire. Lombaire carrying on against Brad Park. They go into the boards along with O'Reilly. Now Brad Park comes up with it, ahead on the boards for Middleton. Not much skating room. They jam in. O'Reilly gets it over to McNabb. Back on the left side and Engblom. Here it at the center. Here's Redmond losing it. Jarvis ahead to Ganey. Back to Jarvis. There's the rising shot. Hughes in the corner trying to center it. Redmond starting out for the Boston Bruins. Ahead it goes. Miller has it. He's down on the right side. Into Middleton. Oh, on the offside. And is Don Cherry ever upset?
Now you can get in great shape. Build muscle. And you can do it fast. All you have to do is dial it up. Turn up the results with the Bowflex Select Tech Free Weight System. Now you can dial up the weight you want, anywhere from 5 to 52 and a half pounds on one single dumbbell. Want 15 pounds? Just turn the dial to 15 and start lifting. Ready for 40? All it takes is the turn of a dial. Now you can get powerful biceps, a sexy core, even chiseled legs in an easy 30-minute workout. Call now to order your Bowflex Select Tech free weight system for no money down and payments as low as $15 a month. Order now and we'll include this free DVD, Secrets of the Four-Step Rep, that teaches you perfect free weight techniques. It's time to turn up your results. Call and get your Bowflex Select Tech for just $15 a month today.
Is your dandruff turning people off? Garnier Fructis Anti-Dandruff Shampoo helps kiss those flakes goodbye and smells amazing. It's proven. From the first wash, no visible flakes. Satisfaction guaranteed. Garnier Fructis Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. Garnier.
Game over for dandruff. Are you the Garnier Fructis ultimate sports fan? Enter online for your chance to win a behind-the-scenes TSN sport experience of your choice. Like a major golfing event with Rod Black. Garnier Fructis Anti-Dandruff Shampoo.
All-new 2005 Hyundai Tucson, winner of the Ajax Best New Crossover Vehicle Award. Perfect for whatever, whenever.
Well, Gary, one of the Canadians' best penalty killers, Doug Jarvis, has been eliminated as he's in the penalty box.
Well, on this particular play, Cashman was heading for the front of the net like he's supposed to do, and Jarvis, of course, he was trying to stop him, and he pushed him into the net, and he's going to receive that penalty. And the key man now is Watchford Park.
Now the Bruins on the power play. Rattel to Park over on this side to Redmond. He shoots it. Dryden didn't see that one, and it whizzed by the far side. Gilbert out to help Brad Park. Now Redmond along the boards. Where is it, says Redmond. Here it is. I have it. And the Bruins are getting organized to start this power play with Schmatz coming out over the line with Rattel and Marcotte. They clear it in. Rattel going in from the other side. Lapointe knocked it off the board. The boat goes past Brad Park. And down the ice, Redmond to Park. A minute and 18 seconds left in the penalty, and the Bruins, four of them at center. They dump it in. Ganey is in there. Again, he clears it out. Canadians defending very well at this particular juncture, killing off the penalty. Lemaire in there, he'd like to get a whistle in deep Boston territory, but he's not going to get it this time. Redmond from the corner, tank it out. Lemaire sliding it in there. Great work by Lemaire, 25. Risebrough's tied up by Park. Rattel back to Park. And now there are 43 seconds left in the penalty, and the Bruins led by Park ahead to Redmond. He shoots it into the corner. Schmatz is going in after Savard. Savard on the board, has to deal with Marcotte. Now it's Schmatz coming back at the point. Redmond back in, it goes to Schmatz. Over to Rattel. He couldn't get it. Risebrough into the center ice area. Long shot. Bombay into the corner, bumping with Redmond. Now Park. A dozen seconds left in the penalty. The score is tied at a goal. Park over to Redmond. He hits that Montreal line. Drop pass goes to McNabb. Back in. Here's Redmond in behind the net. Middleton trying to send over. Right over the club. Risebrough knocked it away from Marcotte. Jarvis is back on the ice. It's Tremblay winding up for the shot. Now the rebound. Watched carefully by Gilbert. The team's making changes while the play goes on. Middleton is knocked out of the play by Lambert, and the Canadians feed it back in there. Here's Lafleur. Lafleur setting up right in front, and Lambert couldn't get it. The Bruins wheel back. Middleton on the right side, over the line, flipping it in front, and covering up is Dryden.
You know, Dick, on that last power play, the Canadians are anticipating so well. They know that as soon as Boston gets over center ice, they're going to shoot it in. And right away, Savard or Lapointe or whoever is out there just starts backing up right away, and they get to the puck before Bruin even gets there and just dump it out again. No chance for the Bruins that time.
It's an interesting stat on Todd Cherry. I asked him about that game. He said, I took a regular shift, and I got a two-minute penalty for tripping John Bullivant.
Score tied at a goal. Dryden in that crouch. Jarvis against McNabb. Jarvis gets it back to Robinson. He headmans it to Jarvis on the right side in full plate as Napier. Napier over the line, waited too long, and he was checked by Rick Smith. To the other side, Robinson is going to keep it in. Robinson right out in front, and a bounce away from Napier. Here's McNabb firing it out on the right side. Middleton clearing it in. Engblom to Lafleur. Lafleur dashing down, winds up with the shot. He scores! Lafleur! A blistering blast from the right side.
Gary, we are sitting here not 50 feet away from where Guy Lafleur let that shot go. I tell you, I didn't see it. It was absolutely an incredible blast right here.
Well, they've shattered him pretty well tonight, but he happened to get the loose puck here, pick it up, and look at the angle he's at. But he just overpowers Gilbert and then beat him to the far side. Just a tremendous shot, hard shot.
Boy, oh boy, I don't know. You know, you can second guess that Gilbert cut off the angle, but he really didn't have all that much time to react. Milbury might be a bit of a screen right there. Perfectly placed shot. So the Canadians on the first goal now lead 2-1.
There's the announcement. Now there's a shot from a sharp angle by Jonathan. The Bruins to the attack. They are trailing 2-1, and Montreal starting out smartly. Gainey coming in. He drops the back. Mondeau is checked. Brad Park leading a three-man Boston attack. Cashman has it. Back for Park, and it's broken up at the line. We could have a delayed offside. It is.
Scotty Bowman's Canadians have taken the lead at 7:58 here in the second period. It was Guy Lafleur, his fifth playoff goal from Brian Engblom.
Now the play on again with 11 minutes and 28 seconds left in the second period. Canadians shooting it down the ice. Tim's back there after it, and it's icing against Montreal.
Of course, it's only natural that when you have a goal scored against you, you're losing 2-1. Your head seemed to droop on that bench. Now, it's up to your leaders on the club, you know, the Park, the Rattel, the Cashman, you know, to remind everybody, you know, we've got lots of time. Let's regroup and start going to the offense here and get things going again. You know, you just can't sag, because that's usually when another goal gets scored against you.
Right now, the Bruins with the defense well in over the line for this faceoff. Into the corner, Smock playing it around to the other side. Lapointe bumping with Rattel. Fishing it out is Jarvis. Jarvis shooting it in over the line. And that's Milbury taking a look over his shoulder at Risebrough. Milbury can't clear it against Chartrand. Now he gets another shot at it. Middleton trying to propel it out over the line. The Canadians play doggedly, but they can't keep it in. Here is Rattel. Rattel back to Schmaltz. There's the shot. And Dryden covers up. Schmaltz was able to get something on that despite his incapacity.
Well, I was going to say there wasn't anything wrong with his wrist, arm, elbow, shoulder, whatever you were discussing in that first period on that shot off the pass from Rattel.
Oh, we saw the playmaking of Rattel there, hitting that open man. And one thing about Schmaltz, not only does he have a heavy shot, but he gets it away so fast. And Dryden had to be ready for that one.
To recap that game in New York in the second period, 1-1. The Rangers scored at 1:18, Don Maloney. But 35 seconds later, Tonelli tied it for the Islanders.
Again, the Bruins with the defense up. And Rick Smith has it. He snapped it off the corner board. There is Marcotte going after Lafleur. Foster in there. McNabb too. Nobody in front of the net. Three players in the corner. Now Canadians starting out. Stopped by Foster. Robinson has on the right side. Milbury clearing it out. Engblom returns it in over the line. And we have Lafleur moving in with Napier and Lemire to forecheck. However, the Bruins start out. O'Reilly lost it. There's a lead pass, and Lafleur was out of position. Net is empty, but Lafleur couldn't pick it up. Foster ahead to Marcotte. Over it goes to O'Reilly. Drop pass, and Lafleur on some excellent back checking was there and took it away just as Brad Park was ready to pick it up and blast it. Now O'Reilly at his own line lost it. Park does that Savardian spinorama play. Now Park again with it. Doing some great work for Boston. Park in over the line. He bumps with Engblom. He falls. Here's Lambert with Trombley. Lambert takes a look. Tries to center it. Excellent defensive play there that time by Sims. Robinson over to a vacated point. Engblom moves up. There's the shot. Back to Robinson. Pressure here by Montreal. A backhand shot. Loose puck. And it's cleared away by Foster. And he falls along with Trombley. Bruins having difficulty getting up. Now they get it to the line. Not up. Foster is going to try it. Mondeau has it. There's the shot. And he rattled that one off the kneecap of Sims. That was headed for the far side. Robinson back for Montreal. Into Mondeau. He shoots. And Gilbert, a big save. Right in front of Cook. Oh, what a remarkable and miraculous save that was. Let's take a look at it.
Yeah, that puts the end to some tremendous pressure on the part of the Canadians. We'll look at it in a moment. The Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Boston Garden.
Have you ever accidentally overfilled a gas tank? It happens every day, causing real environmental damage. You can help stop that damage with Flow & Go. Only at Home Hardware or Home Building Center. And now there's a Flow & Go for larger fuel tanks. So
more than twice the fuel flow, heavy gauge hose, and a full guarantee. With Flow & Go, there are no harmful spills and no wasted fuel. Pick up either Flow & Go today, or both, only at Home Hardware and Home Building Center. Help close to home.
Here I am, 50 years old, and I'm out in a bikini, and that makes me feel very good.
How can a 50-year-old grandmother look this good? Simple. She strength trains with Bowflex.
I'm 50 years old and I have a Bowflex body.
Call the number on your screen now to get a free video or DVD that shows you how you can get great results with Bowflex.
My results are very real. I lost 17 pounds in the first 5 weeks on my Bowflex. I'm leaner, I'm happier, I'm sexier than I've ever been.
All it takes for great results is one simple workout done 20 minutes a day, 3 days a week.
It's safe, it's reliable, and I can get a good workout from head to toe.
Own your very own Bowflex Extreme for no money down and payments of just $18 a month. No matter what your age, if you want real results, you need a real Bowflex. Call us for a free DVD or video or visit us online today.
Makeup meltdown? Not on this street. New two-step Outlast makeup. The prep step smooths pores, shine is gone. So the makeup stays fresh, stays flawless, stays on. New Outlast makeup in the silvery blue box. Easy, breezy, beautiful cover girl.
Gary, the action's been all one way here the last few minutes. Tremendous pressure by Montreal.
The Canadians are coming in waves, and if you ever want to play to pick a team up, watch this one. It looks like it's going to go over the line, and somehow out comes the glove and make the big save. Great save by Gilbert there.
Well, that you hit it right on. It'll be interesting to see now on this break and the face-off if the Bruins can get some life from that great stop. Tremendous second effort, as it's called, by Gilbert. They are repairing the ice in the Boston goal crease, and Gilbert steals the water bottle from the officials in the process and takes a quick swig of it. Dougie Jarvis, and there is his record to this moment tonight in faceoffs. Of course, he's one of the best, and tonight he's having a good night.
Now, Montreal with the defense of Savard and Lapointe laying up. Chartrand takes it to the corner, flicked it behind the net. Milbury is bumped by Gainey. Puck into the center ice area. Montreal 2, Boston 1. Moving into the final 8.5 minutes of the second period. Canadians rolling it back to center. Milbury. He bumps with Jarvis. Chartrand over to Gainey. Gainey back to Chartrand. Jarvis trying to get it. Milbury rolls it down on the right side. They rush in after Savard. Savard plays it to center. Jarvis has it. Into the corner. There's Gainey going in. Chartrand's getting in front and hit the side of the net. Rick Smith clearing it to the other side. Now Cashman has it. Miller moving up on the play. Cashman is in on the left wing. Cashman centering it. Back to Rick Smith. There's the shot. High shot. Oh, that had plenty on it, but it was a rising shot away over the top of the net. Now it is Savard failing to clear it out the first time, gets the second opportunity, it's back down the ice. And Brad Hunt over on the far side. O'Reilly is on the ice to Rattel. Rattel is knocked off the puck by Robinson. Lafleur back to Engblom to Robinson. Robinson striding up on that left side. He hopped by Park and Rattel, trying to center it. Now O'Reilly can't get it. There's Napier with a shot right on the rebound. Cleared by Sims to center. Here's Lafleur. He did not get out of the zone, so it's offside.
Boy, has there ever been a player the size of Larry Robinson with the agility of Larry Robinson?
Well, you know. He adds such a great dimension to the Montreal attack. You know, once he's got the puck and he sees an opening, away he goes, and somebody just drops by or drops back to cover his spot. But all of a sudden, you had a 3-on-1 or a 3-on-2. Now it's 4-on-2.
7 minutes and 3 seconds, the time left in the second period. Here is Park. He shoots it in. Robinson is on it. Almost hit Lafleur with it. There's Napier going in. Gilbert is upended. But the Bruins, fortunately for them, they get the puck and they start back. There's Marcotte. Center right in front. Here's Bobby Schmuck. Schmuck, center right in front of Mattel. He scores! Mattel!
What a tremendous setup that was by Schmuck. Boy, oh boy. You know what? Also, Rattel is heading for the net. Had his stick on the ice. Boom, it's in. Just a great play.
Well, it's a case of the Bruins making the most of their opportunities, which haven't been very many in this second period. No doubt about this one on the shot by Rattel.
You know, Montreal was certainly had all the better of the play the last 6 or 7 minutes and, you know, could have increased their lead. And all of a sudden, the Bruins come back just by a good passing play there and get right back in it again.
Here, if you recall, on the play preceding it in the Boston zone, Gilbert came out of the net, and Napier got all tangled up and was eliminated by being knocked down, and he was out of the play. The Canadians were actually caught with a man short, and it paid off as Rattel found the room. 2-2, we've got a tie hockey game. Here's what happened to Napier right here as he gets caught between Sims and Gilbert. The Bruins head back up the ice, and Napier never did catch up with the play, and it's a tie game.
I'll tell you, most of these goal scorers, as soon as that puck is on the stick, boom, it's on the net. And Rattel, he didn't hesitate. It was there, and he just let it go and had Dryden a little out of position. He couldn't react fast enough, and it's a tie game.
Well, if you had a pass in front of the net, there's no other player on the team you'd sooner have in front there to pick up that pass because he knows what to do with it. The Bruins have tied it. It's 2-2, 6.5 minutes left in the second period. Rick Smith ahead to Middleton, to McNabb. Now they chase it into the center ice area. A snapshot into the corner by O'Reilly. O'Reilly and Tremblay had a collision, but they apologized to each other. That's something I didn't expect, but it happened. Now into the center ice area. O'Reilly and Tremblay go down again, but this time there's no apology. Now in behind the net. Up on the wing, there's O'Reilly and Tremblay. McNabb a shot. Rebound. Lapointe on the right side. Something is going to break out, I think, between Tremblay and O'Reilly. Not this time, because the change is being made. Savard forced back in his own zone. Gets it up on the right side. Milbury. Miller let it go by, going in after it. Savard is being chased by Miller. Savard is knocked to the ice. Now on the right side, Mondou to Lambert. He hits that Boston line, barging in there as Hughes, upended by Jonathan. Now Redmond bumps his man. There's a shot and a big leg save on Mondou by Gilbert. Canadians with the pressure, but now the Bruins clear it into the center ice area. In there goes Foster. Robinson to Mondou. Tremendous action in the last couple of minutes. Here's Mondou with that head fake. In over the line. Mondou trying to center it. And it goes over the glass. What tremendous moves Mondou has.
Rattel from Smotson Park at 13:21. The Boston scoring play. It's a 2-2 tie. Live from the Boston Garden, the Stanley Cup playoff.
Of all the riches in the world, which do you thirst for? Is it the magic of gold? Bright, crisp, clean and pure, with a luster few can match. Does your cup runneth over? It's your kingdom. Bask in the glow.
My name is Jess Gessner. I lost 115 pounds with Bowflex. I was 25 years old. I was 310 pounds. I had a 44-inch waist. Looking back at how big I was then, it's hard to believe that I look good as I feel I look now.
If you want great results like Jess, then call for a free video or DVD from Bowflex. And now, through this special offer, you can own the new Bowflex Extreme with no money down and payments of just $18 a month.
It's empowering. You feel great. You just, like, I can conquer the world because this machine just makes you feel that good and makes you that strong.
The Bowflex Extreme is backed by a 7-year warranty and comes with a 6-week, 100% satisfaction guarantee.
I know other guys who ate sandwiches and lost a lot of weight, but I don't see them on TV with their shirt off.
Call us now or visit us online for your free DVD or video. Find out how to get your Bowflex Extreme for just $18 a month. Call now.
Little pointer here, guys. Power windows are not toys.
It was an accident.
Let's get in the car, guys.
With childproof power windows, optional all-wheel drive, and the highest crash test rating, the 2005 Suzuki Ariya.
Scotty Bowman in the pressure cooker, as they say, in cliche form here again tonight. McNabb showed deceptive speed going down there. Perhaps Gary will talk about the speed that is deceptive by the big boys when he has an opportunity. Right now, we pick up the play. Sims over on the far side, O'Reilly to McNabb. He knifes it into the corner. Middleton after the point. Chartrand ran into O'Reilly. Here's Sims shooting it. Not much on that shot, but it was partially screened and went wide. Here's Gainey. Dropping it into the corner, 2.5 minutes left in the second period. Gainey getting it back to the point to Engblom. In it goes, Sims in the corner, firing it around the board. Here's Trombley going in. Rondo couldn't get it, it's centered again. Middleton over on the far side. McNabb at the line, couldn't get by Robinson. Now the Middlebury. Gainey gets it in front. A lead pass for Miller. Miller is being watched by Engblom. Miller was taken down by Engblom. And there is a conviction among the Bruins, their coach and their fans, that there should have been a penalty on that. Cashman shooting it. In on the board. Lambert ahead to Mondeau. Mondeau putting on the brakes. Andu still with it, winds up, there's the shot, another shot, and it hit bodies in front of Gilbert. Is that Wally Harris who checked Lambert? Now Jonathan couldn't catch up to it. There's an offside.
Minute 17 left here in this second period. Not quite the sustained action throughout we had in the first, but we've had two goals, Lafleur for the Canadiens, Rattel for the Bruins, and it's 2-2.
On the faceoff, Park. Shooting it in, there is Savard. We have Rattel, Mark Cotton, Schmatz on for the Bruins once again. Lafleur, Napier, and Lemaire. There's Napier in the corner. Napier getting set around the net. Lafleur is looking for a pass that doesn't come out, less than a minute to go. Now here's Napier to Lafleur right in front, and he was turned around. Knox is going after it against Savard. Now Marcotte follows in. Marcotte trying to pass it back. Score tied at 2 goals, 35 seconds left, and this is the second period. Montreal, Lemaire into the center ice area over the line. There's the shot, and it goes off Sims over the glass to the right of Gilbert.
That last play with Napier, and he might have tried to set up the wrong Guy. Lafleur was turned around, but Lapointe was cruising in with that side of the net wide open. Close call.
Here we're going to see it again, and it's amazing how Lafleur will get himself into a good position. There he's cruising in front of the net, but now he just turns around, and he wasn't expecting the pass at that particular time. A good break for the Bruins. That line is starting to move, too, now.
Jarvis Gainey. There's Engblom shooting it. He wrapped it off the leg. It went to the corner, a wild pileup. In front of Gilbert, Rick Smith and Gainey were in there. There's another pile up, and they get a face-off With 14 seconds left in the second period, there is a nervous-looking fan.
Bruin fan, I am sure.
Is that Mrs. Cherry?
I don't know. It isn't blue, I'll tell you that.
Well, you know, Gary, the reason why I asked, Dick is right up to date on all these social developments.
Not that one.
There's the master. We saw him over there. Don Cherry, the master of the dog named Blue. So they're a bit fractious here because this is an important face-off in fairly deep Bruin territory. The Bruins get it. Rick Smith fires it. And the players on the Canadiens bench had to do some ducking.
Now with 10 seconds left, you're looking at an important face-off. And Jarvis, of course, is out there, has had a real good night face-off-wise. And Rattel comes out for the Boston Bruins. You know what Freddie Shiro used to do in the last couple of seconds, last minute, put two centermen out in case one of them is thrown out of the face-off. And in fact, he would want the first two men to be thrown out so the other man could take it.
Ever pay off in a goal?
Sometimes,
I guess.
You know, if you get your top center iceman or your top faceoff man, the other team is out there, he gets thrown out. Now you have to put a winger in there, and you got a great chance of beating him.
Roy Harris almost was hit by the debris that came down out of the second balcony here at the Garden.
Roll of tissue.
So the Bruins have Rattel, Park, Smith, Marcotte, and Cashman, Jarvis, Chartrand, Gainey, Engblom, and Robinson. 10 seconds. And there you see the move prematurely. And this is the type of situation the time is difficult to get them steady. However, Park has it, and I guess that will be it. It's into the center ice area. We have 3 seconds. Now 2 seconds and the period is over. Gilbert and Dryden continue to sparkle 2-2 at the end of two.
The action hero.
New from Delco, it's Mama's Boy. He never panics because he doesn't risk leaving his mama.
Mom, I can't feel my legs.
Stay put, Marshall. Do you want to get kidnapped?
Mama's Boy comes with internal magnets that prevent separation and a pull-string mama doll with 6 different guilt trips.
You'll miss me when I'm dead.
Also available, the wuss and sucker.
Some men never take risks. For men who do take risks, there's new degree for men. With twice the odor protection you need, it won't let you down.
Ah, the life. Warm sun, fresh breezes, and good friends. As you share Canada's great outdoors with friends and family, discover why Broil King gas grills have gained a reputation for superior quality, craftsmanship, and cooking performance. Designed and built right here in Canada to uncompromising standards, Broil King can turn the ordinary into the extraordinary. Enjoy a taste of the good life. Broil King. Great barbecues every time.
New 2005 Hyundai Tucson, winner of the Ajax Best New Crossover Vehicle Award. Perfect for whatever, whenever.
The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway.
Wherever life takes you, Best Western is there. Best Western, the world's largest hotel chain.
So now we have Rattel at center, Marcotte on one wing and Schmatz on the other. Lemaire, Napier, and Lafleur, the Canadians clear it in. And very quickly they change. They have Chartrand on, along with Gainey and Jarvis. Here's Gainey coming in on that left side. He falls against Park. They go to the corner. And the puck is loose in behind the net. Park trying to tie up Chartrand. Jarvis in there, twisting and turning to shortstop, and it burst! And Gainey missed the open side. What a gorgeous setup that was. He let it go all in the one motion. He was just wide with it. Now the puck goes down the ice into Canadiens territory, and Chartrand back there. That's the opportunity for Don Cherry to make changes. Canadiens starting out. They clear it into the center ice area. Rick Smith behind the net up on the left side. Middleton ahead to Rattel. Rattel shooting it in. Now then, Savard. Score tied 2-2 early in the third period. Savard shooting it in for Montreal. That is the Canadian strategy, obvious to everyone, starting this the third period. They want to keep it in. There's Lemaire shooting it to the corner to Lafleur. A sharp angle shot. Robinson at the point, cleared it back in. Here's Lafleur after it again. He tried to center it. The Bruins sweep it to the line. Marcotte dumped it delicately down on the left side, and Robinson has it there for the Canadiens. On it in the center ice area, Rick Smith. Robinson ahead to Napier. Here's Rick Smith into O'Reilly on the backhand, and that one went off Napier. Napier around the net, gathering speed, making a move, coming out into the center ice area. Stopped by McNabb. Into Marcotte. Marcotte centered it. O'Reilly was upended, and again the fans react. Here's Robinson over the line. Robinson takes a look to the other side. Engblom trying to get it. And Marcotte has it out to McNabb into the center ice area. He shoots it in. Now on the left side. Lemaire trying to pick it up at center. Park has it for Boston. We're in the third period. Park shooting it right on. Dryden hands it off to Lambert. It's kept in by Jonathan. The cashman to Jonathan. The backhand shot. Another shot. Dryden is down. And Jonathan appeared to have the tie-breaking goal. Boston coming very close. There's Miller shooting a long one. Robinson ahead on the left side. Lambert couldn't get it. Park off the boards. Engblom has it into the center ice area to the Boston line. And Miller cleared it back to center. Here's Savard for Montreal waiting for Lambert to get onside. And Trombley is offside.
Well, a look at the TV broadcast positions. Our co-frères from La Soirée de Hockey, René Lecavalier, Lionel Duval, and Gilles Trombley. And there you see your commentators. And there you see the action set for the face-off in the Boston zone.
It's very exacting doing a game from the crowd here at the Boston Garden, but these wonderfully knowledgeable people supply great atmosphere. And I think we'll make it all the way through. Right now, it's a tie hockey game, 2-2. Now right in front, it comes and Gainey missed that pass. It was sent out by Hughes, and Gainey couldn't connect in front. Canadians clearing it in again behind the net. Milbury cleared it up on the wing to O'Reilly. McNabb couldn't get it. Now McNabb gets it a second time, going in on that left side. An eye-high shot. O'Reilly on the boards with Middleton. Here's Middleton to McNabb. McNabb around the net, jammed out of the play by Lapointe. And they'll get a whistle here for a face-off. To the right of Dryden, 11:24 left in regulation time. The score tied to 2 goals.
Yeah, so far this has been a period of missed opportunities. Saturday night, game 5 at the Forum in Montreal. 8 o'clock, our broadcast time start, Eastern time. And this one, who knows? This could go right down to 7. They both could. As the series here is exactly as it is in New York. One team ahead 2-1, and the games are exactly identical at 2-2 in the third period.
So Rattel, who has both goals for Boston, is at center. There's a shot. It hits Mops in front. Lapointe ahead to Napier. He gets it into the center ice area. There's Sims clearing it up. Lafleur intercepting ahead on the left side to Risebrow. Rattel coming out with Schmatz. Here's Rattel. He has Marcotte on the other side. Rattel back to Sims. There's a shot. Schmatz had the open net. Here come the Canadians. Risebrow shooting it in. Lafleur going in there. into the corner. Mark caught against Risebrow. Sims trying to cover up. Up on the left side, Marcotte getting it to the line. Not out, now Marcotte is into the center ice. Here he is, goes off a leg. It's picked up by Sims over the line. There's the shot. And he rattled up and off the right leg of LaPointe. 10 minutes and 25 seconds left in regulation time, 2-2. The Bruins keeping it in. Here's Rick Smith. And LaPointe cleared it down on the right side. Knott back there turning for the Boston Bruins. Up on the left side, Milbury to Jonathan. He cleared it in, and Robinson has it, making that move against Jonathan. Up on the left side to Engblom. Engblom is over the line, takes a look, drops it back. Mondu, a turnaround shot. He's wide. Here's Trombley on the boards against Miller. Milbury and Lob there moved in. They get a stoppage in play.
With the score, Montreal 2, Boston 2. This is Stanley Cup 79.
Oh, man, take mine.
Thanks.
Nah, I'd love to spend my holidays up here. I got no place to stay.
You can use my cottage.
Kevin, it's okay?
Susie dumped me.
Have you met Julie? It's the last one.
Moose Light. Enjoy your nature.
Armor All. Put it on, and it's always there. It's strong protection.
We really just want to make sure he can pick any university he wants.
Okay, let's have a look.
What do you see in the future? A financial security advisor from Freedom 55 Financial can help you get there. Because financial planning is about more than just retirement. It's about making things happen in every stage of your life. So keep dreaming, but start planning.
So you know what? Here's how we can help make this work.
Freedom 55 Financial. The freedom to choose, the power to get there.
The sound, the performance, the excitement, the fast and the furious. For that deep, powerful sound, it's Dynamax Performance Mufflers. Right now, get up to $75 back at Minute and Speedy Muffler Break and Wheel. For that unique tuner sound, it's DMX Performance Systems designed for today's import vehicles. And right now, you save 30%. Plus, enter to win a trip to Universal Studios Hollywood, the world's largest movie studio and theme park. Minute and Speedy Muffler Break and Wheel, your performance experts.
NHL Classic Series, showcasing the greatest Stanley Cup playoff series ever played.
The pass, Sakic, scores!
The best of 1993, Classic Series, all week on the NHL Network.
8:29 left in the third period, Rattel against Lemaire. Montreal, everybody up, back to LaPointe, he chopped at it, now Savard. Goes to the left side. Lafleur keeping it in for Montreal. Here's Gainey. Gainey trying to center it. LaPointe takes a shot and a miraculous save by Gilbert. Now Park shooting it to the far side. Canadians with pressure on. A weak shot by Lafleur. Lemaire against Park. Schmutz cleared it into the center ice area. Gainey has it knocked off his stick by Rattel. Now LaPointe, score tied 2-2, Lafleur starting out, Lemaire couldn't come up with it. Redmond starting back for Boston and over the line. Now here's Smuts. Smuts getting set, a backhand shot! And again, in rapier-like fashion, Dryden put out that left hand. The angle was sharp, but he came up with a brilliant save. He was taking no chances whether or not that was going to miss the net. Now McNabb into the center ice area to O'Reilly. Here's O'Reilly going in on goal! And Dryden out on the short stop. He blocked it. Now Risebrow on the left side. It goes over to Napier on the other wing. Milbury clearing it ahead. Here's Napier trying to set up Risebrow. And the clock shows exactly 7 minutes left in regulation time. McNabb clearing it in. Middleton going in there. O'Reilly on the other side. Here's Milbury. It came out over the line and the call offside.
don't know how long we have to wait for the next goal, Gary, but we may have to wait a long time for the next penalty.
I think at this stage of the game, it certainly will have to be a type of penalty where it's going to affect the outcome of a goal. But just tremendous action here.
A chance for Lapointe. Lemaire tried to get his stick on it. I don't think he did. I think Gilbert got the leg out before. I can't remember, Danny, in the last 2 years when these teams played in the finals, this type of sustained offensive action.
No, I would think the last two games particularly have been the outstanding games in the playoffs of recent years between the Bruins and the Canadiens.
That's just been tremendous action, and I think the Canadiens are very fortunate right now. You know, Dryden was kind of overshadowed Tuesday night because he lost, but he has come up with about four or five saves this period to keep Montreal at even.
So the puck at the Canadiens line, it's returned in across the line by Jonathan. Cruising in there is Miller, he has Cashman on the right side. Robinson coming out rather carefully, now on the right side. Engblom at center shoots it to the line, and Jonathan knocked it down on the wing, score tied at two. Engblom fell but hooked it out. Now Miller on the left side. He cams it off the corner boards to the other side. Cashman, he lost it to Lambert. Ahead to center to Mondeau. Mondeau taken off the puck by Cashman. Rick Smith, he failed to hit Jonathan with it. Dryden again out of the net. There's Robinson against Cashman. Robinson leading a four-man Canadiens attack into the center ice area across the line. In it goes to Lambert. Cashman is there. He clears it up on the right side. Here's Jonathan coming in. Miller is with him. Jonathan takes a look. He slides it into Dryden. And it's Lapointe from the corner to Robinson on the left wing. 5 minutes and 35 seconds left. Cashman upended Robinson. Now it's at the line to Puck. Park over to Sims at center. Long shot. The teams are making changes while the play goes on. Savard coming out. The Bruins breaking it up. Marquardt lobbed it over the line for Schmott. Schmott losing it to Jarvis ahead to Gainey. Here's Gainey in on the left side. Gainey cutting in there, having difficulty controlling it. Into the corner. Here's Sims coming out. At the line, ahead to Marquardt with Schmott over the line. And Savard takes over for Montreal and gives it to Gainey. Gainey down on the left side, shooting it in. Now Chartrand moves in, but the Bruins take over. Middleton, a long lead pass for Schmott. Up on the left side. Now Napier gathering speed, hits that Boston line. Here's Napier. Along the boards, LeFleur comes up with it. There's a pass. Here's Middleton starting out. Middleton over the line. Middleton getting set to center it. He can't. Now it's McNabb taken out of the play by Lapointe. Lemaire handing it off to Savard. Savard ahead on the left side for LeFleur. He's being hounded by Rick Smith. And McNabb ahead, it goes to O'Reilly. O'Reilly down on the right wing. Robinson watching him. Now O'Reilly gets it. He dumped it to McNabb. Lemaire starting on the left side. He couldn't get out. Robinson is coming up with LeFleur, who got rid of it. Milbury to O'Reilly up on the left side to McNabb. Here's McNabb going in. He fired it. He scores! McNabb!
Just ended a sequence of some of the best hockey you will ever see. And with 3 minutes and 42 seconds left in regulation time, the Boston Bruins lead Montreal 3-2.
Just look at this move. It looks like McNabb is going to cut towards the inside, and then he switches direction and just gets by Engblom. Looks like he lost the puck and ends up on a stick and fires it past Dryden, but great puck control there.
You know, Engblom made a good play to begin with, Gary. And the puck just came right off him, right back to McNabb, who reacted perfectly.
See, even Dryden was moving right to the other side of the post there and couldn't get back in time.
Peter McNabb, the hero of the moment here at the Boston Garden. There you see the reaction of these tremendously partisan Boston fans. That's the way it should be. And the home team has the lead. They haven't found their seats yet. They are still standing throughout the Boston Garden.
Well, you know, in this third period, the Bruins have had about four or five real good scoring chances, close-in chances that either the puck went wide or Dryden came up with a big save. And it looked like it was just a matter of time. And finally, McNabb, so far, what a hero he's going to be.
You know, I was finding myself wondering, when are they going to stop? When are we going to get the next whistle? It was just tremendous action.
I've had a relatively easy third period.
Both of us. Danny's done all the work. Larry Robinson was trapped on the play. Engblom back. McNabb made the most of that glittering opportunity. Live from the Boston Garden, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Clive MacDonald works for Shell's Global Fuels Research. At first glance, he's an unlikely presence at Ferrari's test track.
This is the closest I've ever been to a racing car. To be frank, this scared the life out of me.
He's part of a global team that designs fuel here and tests it here and keeps Shell on track in our search for the cleanest, most efficient fuels possible. It's experts like Clive who give us all a head start.
My name is Jess Gessner. I lost 115 pounds with Bowflex. I was 25 years old. I was 310 pounds. I had a 44-inch waist. Looking back at how big I was then, it's hard to believe that I look good as I feel I look now.
If you want great results like Jess, then call for a free video or DVD from Bowflex. And now, through this special offer, you can own the new Bowflex Extreme with no money down and payments of just $18 a month.
It's empowering. You feel great. You just, like, I can conquer the world because this machine just makes you feel that good and makes you that strong.
The Bowflex Extreme is backed by a 7-year warranty and comes with a 6-week, 100% satisfaction guarantee.
I know other guys who ate sandwiches and lost a lot of weight, but I don't see them on TV with their shirt off.
Call us now or visit us online for your free DVD or video. Find out how to get your Bowflex Extreme for just $18 a month. Call now.
Say goodbye to color that feels dry and enter the world of Hydrance, where color is lush, rich, and now stays radiant longer because Hydrance has reemerged with new double-sized Pantene After Color Therapy. First, the rich color cream envelops hair, then Pantene penetrates deep to keep your color radiance longer than before. It's color so lush you'll only want more. Hydrance with Pantene. Feels like heaven, looks color wonderful.
They are just now beginning to sit down. The majority of the fans are still cheering this young man, Peter McNabb. Look at it again, Gary. He fanned him that first shot, I think.
Yes, he did, and then caught it again. But, you know, it's very important now for Boston not to get caught up in all the enthusiasm here with the fans cheering. They still have a job to do, and, you know, it's very important that they play good, sound, positional hockey.
Robinson on the left wing as the Canadians have to come back.
So with Boston leading 3-2, the play is on again, 3 minutes and 35 seconds left in regulation time. Here's Rattel trying to center it against Lemire. Smuts is around the net. Smuts getting set to center, right over the front, there's a shot! A big save on Marcotte by Dryden. The Bruins pressing the Canadiens. That's the best way they figured to protect this one-goal lead. Here's Rattel setting it right inside, and the Canadiens. Robinson knocking it off to the side. So Lafleur starts down on the right wing. Cleared it in for Lemire. Hart knocked it back to center. Savard over on the other side. Here's Marcotte lobbing off to the corner. Savard in there, and this is a noisy Boston Garden. Puck goes down the ice. Canadians are going to be called for icing.
That goal was McNabb from O'Reilly at 16-18. Gary, just before that, you had mentioned how Dryden had come up with several big saves. While the action was back and forth, the Canadians were, I guess, guilty, if you will, of not finishing their plays to really test Gilbert to the extent that the Bruins were testing Dryden. So there you see it with 2:44 left in regulation time.
You know, from Boston's standpoint now, when they're in Montreal's zone, it's so very important that they just don't throw that puck blind in front of the net, allowing Montreal to come back. Hang on to it until you can make the good play to a teammate. Either that or the worst that can happen is you freeze it for a faceoff.
Well, I would say that Boston is being enveloped with an interest comparable to that which appeared in the heyday of Bobby Orr. Face off to the left of Dryden. And now Wally Harris telling the Montreal Canadiens that they can't make further changes. 2:44 left in regulation time. We have Mondu on with Gainey. And Napier against Miller, Cashman, and Jonathan. Canadians get the draw, the point ahead to Napier, down on that right side and over the line, there's the shot. And it went off the leg of Milbury. Rick Smith to the other side, it's on the dasher board and rolls back into Canadians territory. The point, time, a big factor now for Montreal. They need a goal to tie it up. There's Gainey digging doggedly on the right side, cleared it in. Cashman returns it down to the Montreal line. The point. Over it goes to Gainey with Napier on the right side. Here's Napier over the line with Lambert. He gives it to Lapointe, going in. He scores! Lapointe!
We have 2:06 left in regulation time, and it's tied 3-3. Gary, you were so right. They gave the Canadians some room inside their own blue line.
You just can't give the zone away. You know, you have to make the Canadians shoot it in. The Bruins allowed the Canadians to come over the line, and look at how wide open Lapointe is, and he just fires it through, amazed the players, right through Gilbert's leg.
Napier made the play as he brought the puck up over the line. Played pretty well tonight. Now here's Lapointe. He has lots of room just to crank up and let go, and it's 3-3. That time, that goal at 17:54.
Lapointe, Napier assisting. Gainey also gets an assist. Here's McNabb going in a goal. He fired it. And a splendid save. One of many made tonight by the goalies. That one by Dryden.
McNabb, he certainly has the knack of getting himself in the clear, and he's harassed by Savard, and that may have affected his shot, but Dryden comes up big. Here we see it from behind Dryden. Now, look, I don't know. Maybe he did get a good shot away, but the big guy was there.
Quite a night in the semifinals. They are into overtime in New York, the Islanders and the Rangers.
Now Boston, everybody up with 1:40 left, and Guy Lapointe is brought down by Middleton. Got it to Gainey over on the other side. Trombley chasing it in. Sims to McNabb. McNabb had that glorious, glittering opportunity to put Boston ahead again, as he did earlier, but Dryden robbed him. Now the Canadians coming back. A pass goes off a body out over the line. Trombley turned around by O'Reilly. O'Reilly in over the line. O'Reilly shooting it. Dryden got his arm on it. Now Middleton giving it to O'Reilly. They fight furiously in behind the net. Here's Middleton. He centered it, and it went by the lip of the crease into the corner. Less than a minute to go in regulation time. Here's Middleton. Middleton getting set in behind the net. It's high in the air. Here's Middleton again centering it, and Lemaire cleared it to Trombley. Trombley coming out with Gainey. Gainey down on the left side, scoops it into Boston territory. Milbury, 37 seconds left. Score is tied at 3. Milbury ahead to O'Reilly. He falls. Canadians clearing it out over the line. Now here's Rattel ahead to O'Reilly. He bounced that one in there. He had to be very careful with that. Here's Brad Putt. Raked into the boards by Lambert. Lemaire got rid of it. Down the ice it goes. That will be icing. Whoa. Big face-off with 6 seconds left in regulation time.
Can't read his mind from here, Gary. Look to me the way Lemaire flipped that puck. He just wanted to lob it so that it would fall, you know, dead, as it were, just to get it out into the neutral zone, into the blue line. It went all the way. And there is a face-off in the Canadian zone with 6 seconds left. This is just like overtime right here.
Well, a situation where you know that Jarvis is going to be out there. And I don't know if Scotty Bowman has called his timeout or not. He's talking to Jarvis right now.
Well, they've got Dwight Foster, who won the draw from Jarvis, setting up the first Boston goal here on Tuesday night. Foster hasn't played very much tonight, but he is also a very adept man at winning the draw. So he is out there against Doug Jarvis.
Well, if the Bruins get the draw cleanly, there certainly is enough time to get a good shot on net.
Parks the man. They got Dick Redmond back there as well. They're both inside the blue line. They can both fire the puck.
So a big face-off, the Bruins with Park and Redmond. They have good shots from the point. They're in over the line. Let's see who gets that draw. Wally Harris noticed that a player was out of position. He wants Robinson back. From the face-off, back it goes to Brad Park. In for Markov, he fired it wide. 1 second, that's it, and we're going to have overtime.
So Jill Gilbert and Ken Dryden will be the goaltenders on the spot tonight in overtime. And you have got a situation in the NHL with both games, the semifinals, now heading into overtime. Bruins outshot the Canadians 15-5 in that third period.
New from Delco, it's Mama's Boy. He never panics because he doesn't risk leaving his mama.
Mom, I can't feel my legs.
Stay put, Marshall. Do you want to get kidnapped?
Mama's Boy comes with internal magnets that prevent separation and a pull-string mama doll with 6 different guilt trips.
You'll miss me when I'm dead.
Also available, the wuss and sucker.
Some men never take risks. For men who do take risks, there's New Degree for Men. With twice the odor protection you need, it won't let you down.
The Nissan X-Trail. The small SUV with big heart, big style, big space, big sky, big sound, big utility, and surprisingly, a small price. The Nissan X-Trail, the SUV for evolving lives.
Oasis is coming, which is big news. They played sold-out big shows in big, big stadiums. And after 3 long years, their first North American show is in Canada. But not here.
They're playing in a small club. The first of 3 Molson Canadian Rockstar concerts this summer. You could be there if you open up a specially marked case of Molson Canadian and find a Rockstar access pass. Must be legal drinking age, no purchase necessary. It starts here.
The hot sun is back. Time to break out the armor. And the Armor All wipes. Clean your car inside and out with Armor All. It's strong protection.
With a tremendous reach, he goes in there along the boards. Park taking over. Now Park gets a little skating room, not much. He slaps it off the boards to Marcotte. Marcotte ahead, Middleton going across the line, and it's called on the offside. Score tied at 3. 1 minute has gone by in the overtime.
Yeah, there's Rick Middleton, who I just mentioned has 2 overtime winning goals to his credit. In regulation time, the Bruins outshot the Canadians 29-23. What a setup, Gary, we've got here tonight. Both semifinal rounds, either 2-2 or 3-1. Somebody has scored in New York. Hang on.
Now Milbury. Ahead to Miller. A pass off the body to the far side. There's Lambert taking the look, giving it to Savard. It's returned to Lambert. Lambert is in over that Boston line, shoots it wide from the sharp angle. Now along the boards, Milbury covering up against Lambert. There it goes, Lambert couldn't get it. Jonathan going after it, but longer strides by Savard. Got him there, the more quickly of the two. Now Napier, he has good moves. Coming in on that right side, trying to feed it in front. Here's Napier, over the other side is Savard. Savard draped in on the boards by Cashman. Jonathan, the diminutive but solidly built winger, has it stopped at the line by Engblom. The Bruins clearing it down. On the move is Jonathan against Savard. On the boards, Miller going in to help out, but he can't get it, and the Canadians wheel back into the center ice area. The head fake by Lemaire. He tried to drop it, and then he was dropped himself. Here come the Bruins. Down on the left side, Sims winds up the shot. An easy save for Dryden. There it is up on the far right side, bouncing into Bruin territory. Sims over on the other side. Mark back to Sims. Up on the left side, Mark caught with McNabb. McNabb, the big fellow, is over the line. His shot is blocked by Lapointe. They jam it on the boards. O'Reilly bumping with Mondeau. Here's Marcotte. Back to Sims. Free shot. He didn't miss by much. Now Brad Park going in. He ran into Robinson and fell. LaFleur on the right side. Over Risebrough. The puck was headed for Risebrough, but it hit Sims. Now Risebrough getting set. Back to Robinson, and he grazed the goalpost. A screeching drive, not too high, but he was wide. 16 minutes and 56 seconds left in the first overtime period. The score tied at 3 goals, and the Canadians go to the attack again. LaFleur is over the, or rather Lapointe over the line. He was stopped. Robinson giving it to Tremblay. Robinson back. Now the Bruins are making changes while the play goes on. They have Middleton on, along with McNabb and Schmatz, Ganey, Jarvis and Tremblay for Montreal. Here is Jarvis ahead to Tremblay. Tremblay on the right side. Takes a look, he lost it to Rick Smith ahead to Middleton. Rattel is coming up with the play. Over to Rattel, going in, they score!
Goal by Jean Rattel, his third of the hockey game, and this series is tied 2-2. The Islanders have beaten the Rangers. That series is tied 2-2 for Rattel, his first ever Stanley Cup playoff 3-goal game, and it is only fitting that the dominating person for the Bruins tonight, Jean Rattel, ends this game in overtime after 3 minutes and 36 seconds. And Gary will be back in Boston next Tuesday.
That's for sure. And it was a loose play by the Canadians in the Boston zone, allowed the Bruins to break up. And look at that play by Middleton. Now Rattel's got it. It looks like he's going to release it from that position. Cuts out in front a little further, beats Dryden on that far side for just a tremendous effort. But here's the play. Middleton sends a pass on his backhand over there. Rattel corrals it on his forehand. What a shot. Oh boy, I'll tell you.
Well, no chance for Kenny Dryden. There was a pretty good play by one of the Bruins as he took Savard out, who was trapped on the play, and he tried to get back. What a hockey game, and what a finish.
The Bruins would eventually make good on head coach Don Cherry's promise of a Game 7. They fought back. In fact, Boston was less than 2 minutes away from winning the series before too many men on the ice penalty awakened the forum ghost. And the Bruins ultimately lost that game and the series in dramatic fashion. Thanks for watching Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. We'll see you again next time.
NHL Classic Series.
showcasing the greatest Stanley Cup playoff series ever played.
The pass, Sakic scores!
The best of 1993. Classic Series, all week on the NHL Network. This is the NHL Network.
Welcome to the show. I'm Todd Lewis. Today we'll take a look back at Game 2 of